Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and this is the Colonel. Say hi, Colonel.
Chicken.
Yeah. Hey, everybody. How's it going? Yes, this is Colonel Sanders, the late Colonel Sanders, one of my all-time favorite heroes. What? Because of his deeds in World War II? Well, that's cool, but no. Because of the fact that he had sons in Vietnam? Well, you know, that's cool, but no. Because he revolutionized the restaurant industry? No, but you're getting close. Because he makes great chicken. I'm kidding, guys. No, that's just an inside chicken joke there, you know. I'm full of watermelon and chicken jokes, guys. I mean, come on, guys. If you can't laugh at yourself, then who can you laugh at? But, and I laugh at myself all the time. Well, guys, coming fresh off the tails of my last video, which was a Serbian film video, and I just want to say a few remarks about that, guys, before I move on to the DVD update, with these DVDs actually coming from the pawn shop. Okay, guys, you know, that last video was my feelings about that film, a Serbian film, and I gotta tell you guys, from reading the comments, what really, really surprises me is not only that some people like this film and they consider it an art film, it surprises me that they defend the film. I mean, it just really, and I'm speaking for myself, I'm not speaking for anybody else, but it really just astonishes me that you can have a film that is so utterly disgusting as this film, and someone defends it. I don't know. I guess it just goes back to that old Ramble Raff for Life saying, you know, every film has a lover and every film has a hater, which I think I said that wrong, but you kind of get the gist of that. But yeah, I don't get it, guys. I mean, how can you defend a film and they rationalize things? You know, it's like, I'll say something like, well, you know, this film featured a scene showing a guy screwing a little infant child. And then they rationalize it. Oh, well, that didn't even look real. I don't know, guys. I mean, I could easily say, you know, well, I understand because I like a lot of films that people hate. Yeah, but, you know, I can't even put that into play because the films that I like are nothing as disgusting as that film. So that doesn't even fit in that category. So we can't rationalize it like that. You know, I'm not accusing anybody of anything. All I'm saying is, from my perspective, this is a disgusting film. A sick film. And you know, a lot of people want to say, oh, well, it's just the director going over the lifestyles of Serbia. And, you know, it's just a true accounting of how the government fucks the people. That's a representation of the baby being fucked, and that means you're being fucked when you're born. And then when a little kid was dead at the end of the movie, and they're going to fuck him, you die, and you're getting fucked. Well, I got news for you, Mr. Director. If you want to use that metaphor, that happens in every fucking country. You know, it's been said here in the United States, you're born fucked and you die fucked. You're taxed when you're born, you're taxed when you die. If you want to talk about the government, and a prime example of this, guys, and I just watched Matt's, and I recommend you go back and watch Matt's Ramble Raff for Life's 10 movie rants. The first part he talks about the Serbian film, and we go basically over the same thing. If you're going to talk about metaphorics, or metaphorically, if he wants to talk about the government mistreating, abusing the people, what the fuck does that have to do with a little infant getting screwed? You mean to tell me he couldn't think of anything else as an example? I mean, if you want to use, why not just straight out say it? There's a wrong way to do things and a right way to do things. And this was a wrong way to do it. And like I said in my discussion of the film, guys, I mean, if you're going to have a meaning in a story, don't have all these disgusting images in front of what you're really trying to say. Have the balls to flat out say it. Don't hide behind a little kid getting screwed. If you hate your fucking country that much, leave it. But I can tell you one thing, if you do leave it, you're pretty much going to be fucked wherever you go. So, you know, some people want to defend this film. And then there's these people that say, oh, well, I'm not for sure if I like the film or if I thought it was art. Oh, my fucking God. I'm not calling anybody any names, guys, but, I mean, this is one of those films that I'm pretty sure that I know if I'll like or hate. I don't see how you can be in the middle of that. Now, am I totally blind as far as what I saw in the film? Am I enraged to the point that I don't see anything good in the film? Well, quite frankly, guys, the best thing I can say about this movie is that it was a well-filmed movie. That's it. That's it. I mean, just to me, if you're passionate about the way you're being treated, if you're passionate about your country, your fellow man, the treatment that the government is doing, to me, you're not going to hide that fact in a film that is laced with sexual acts against children. I mean, come on, people. Having a father screw his son in the ass until that little kid starts bleeding, and then you want to say that's just representing, you know, the country's treatment of... Come on! Stop making excuses. My government's mistreating me, so I'm going to represent that. I'm going to show... I mean, and it's not so bad. It's bad enough that not only do they show the guy screwing the kid, they got to add to blood to it. I mean... Okay, I'm done with it. I'm done with it, guys. I'm not going to discuss this film anymore. I've already given it way more time than it deserves. This will just, you know, for people that, you know, the Serbian film, a Serbian film, if it's in their top 10 of best horror films, it's just something that I'll never understand, because to me, the basic human feelings, basic human intelligence, compassion, caring, anybody that's not turned off by seeing a little doll that's representing a little kid and the sound effects of that kid screaming while you see a grown man holding that kid by each arm, legs facing it, and he's just screwing this kid, infant, if you can defend that, I'll never understand that. And that's all I'm going to say about this film. Too much time on it. Okay, welcome to my next DVD and Blu-ray update. As you'll see, guys, there's no Blu-rays here. They are coming, believe me. If you missed it, guys, what I'm doing is I have such a massive DVD update that I'm doing the DVD update, then I'm doing a regular video, then I'm doing a DVD update. But I got to tell you guys, after this DVD update, I've already recorded a review of the film. What the hell was the name of that film? I don't remember. But at the time that I recorded the film, I was a little bit disenchanted with the recording process, how to make these videos look so good. It's a huge file size, takes all night to upload them, takes 3 hours to encode them. And I tried to do it with a lot smaller file size, and I accomplished that, but the picture quality isn't all that great. So, you know, just so you'll know. But I'm not going to stick with it, guys, because I didn't like the overall look of the video. But okay, here we go, guys. Now, these all, like I said, came from the pawn shop, and there's several of them, as you can see, so we're going to get started. This will be another 2 gig file, but this first one is something from my youth. I bought this when I saw it, snatched it off the shelf, couldn't believe it was there. These little animated shorts just stick with me even to today, the music and the subject matter and all that. And this is some that some of you may not recognize if you're a little bit younger, but you older guys will remember. Schoolhouse Rock. Now, I'm just a Bill. Yes, I'm only a Bill. And then we had, Conjunction Junction, what's your function? But these are the little shorts that used to come on Saturday morning that teach you adjectives, pronouns, all those things. And they're just classics, classic stuff. I can't believe I found this at the pawn shop. And I'm definitely glad to have it. It's a two-disc set. And I guess it wasn't important to whoever was selling it because it was only 99 cents. So I got a great, great deal on that. Sorry, Colonel. I'm going to have to move you back here. Okay, guys. Next, we got a couple of double feature DVDs. Now, the first one is a film that I've heard my buddy Matt talk about a whole lot. Matter of fact, it's a film that he likes. I've never seen it. I believe it's put out by Stephen King, though, isn't it? Yeah, it's a Stephen King. Oh, it's directed by, written and directed by Stephen King. I think it was a novel of his, but then we have two movies on this. Now, the first one is Maximum Overdrive, which entails, I think it's like a comet or an asteroid that crosses Earth and the vehicles come to life and starts killing people. And then we have Arnold Schwarzenegger's Raw Deal. I've seen Raw Deal. I thought it was a decent film. But yeah, it's a double feature for 99 cents. Put these there. Next, another double feature. Actually, one of these I'm really, really glad to get because I didn't have this on video. And until I saw it, I didn't really think of the film. But when I saw it, I thought, wow, I remember this film. I liked it a lot. But the double feature, and the first one on here is Prom Night, which I'm assuming is, Jamie Lee Curtis. So it's the original Prom Night, which I've never seen. And then we have The Gate. I remember really liking The Gate. I hope that it's as good as I remember. But to this set, turn this around. Well, it's hard. It's stuck in here, guys. Okay. That's a disc, The Gate. Then we have Prom Night. Both really two nice looking discs. 99 cent, guys. Leslie Nielsen, which one is he in? Is he in Prom Night? Stephen Dorff. I didn't know he was in this either. Great review fodder. Okay, the next one is one of Steven Seagal's films when he was in his prime and he was making all those films where he just was really popular. This is one of my favorites. Marked for Death. I like this movie. Saw it in the theater. Actually has a liner inside it, which is really nice considering it came from a pawn shop. And what's kind of neat about pawn shop movies is a lot of the times the people that actually pawn them really do take good care of them. And like I said, guys, if you go to the pawn shop, I've said it in the past, always check the discs to make sure they're up to your standards. If they're scratched or anything, you don't have to buy them. What really sucks, though, is when you go in there and you want to buy a film that you see one that you really, really want, and then you look at the disc and it's scratched up. That hurts. The next one is a film that Matt reviewed, and he was comparing it to another film. I believe it was the film that he was comparing it to. I can't remember the name, but it had something to do with a dream world or something. He was saying how that film had already been done in this film. Maybe it was Inception he was comparing this film to, but it's called The Cell, The Mind is Her Prison. And I haven't seen this, but I wanted to watch it ever since I saw his review, and then there you go, it's there. It's a really nice cover. I like the cover on this one. The words are kind of embossed so you can feel them. It's one of those clipper cases, those flipper cases, or those lousy, cheapy cases, which I hate. But it's got a ton of features in it. Also, a widescreen version of the film, feature-length commentary by the director, production team, deleted scenes with director's commentary, original documentary style as substance. I mean, it's just full of special features. Visual effects, vignettes, six special effects sequences are explored, DVD-ROM features, theatrical trailer. Now, this is DVD at its finest. And I got to tell you guys, another reason to buy DVD is that a lot of these features aren't available on Blu-ray. Now, if they ever release this on Blu-ray, what do you bet that all these features aren't on the Blu-ray? But there we go, guys. Inside shot of it. A really pretty collection here. Even opens up. Really, really nice. You know, and I got this for 99 freaking cents. Don't tell me I ain't a bargain shopper. Okay, guys. Next we have, wow, one that I've actually watched this one. It stars, I think this is the one. Let's see. Yeah, this one has Chase Masterson in it. She's a... God, I used to see her on Deep Space Nine, just a totally sexy-looking girl on that show. Always wore really sexy outfits. So that's one of the reasons I decided to pick it up. And the fact that it was 99 cents. But this is about a... well, it's called Creature Unknown. And I know it says Blockbuster on there, but it was at the pawn shop. But this is about a creature that's created, and it's created in this underground laboratory in the woods, and it breaks free, and it starts killing these teenagers, of course, and there's kind of a twist story in it that I can't give away. But overall, you know, it's kind of a twist. It's different, so for that I'll give it credit, but overall it's just a low-budget teen flick that just really kind of mediocre. Mediocre? Okay, next we have another low-budget film. You guys know I love collecting monster movies. And I'm going to get back into reviewing monster movies one of these days. But this is one that I believe premiered on the Sci-Fi Channel. But it's put out by Lionsgate. It's Komodo versus Cobra. Wow. Yeah, I haven't seen this one, guys. I can only imagine how great it is. But there's the back of it. Looks like Sylvester Stallone, don't it? Inside of it, I gotta give him credit. At least they put art on the disc. But I'm not expecting a whole lot from that one, guys. But, you know, I like watching those old B-films. Next, we have another low-budget film that I haven't seen this one. It sounded kind of interesting. Ain't It Cool News says a dazzling achievement. I don't know much about it, guys, but it's called Clone. And I love sci-fi, guys. Really love science fiction films. And the thing about sci-fi is that a lot of low-budget sci-fi films offer some really ingenious concepts and stories. So, you know, even though the production values might be cheap and low, a lot of them are still just really good science fiction. The future of billions lies within the mind of one man. And there's the back of it. You can't really see a whole lot on there, but I'm definitely going to give it a look, guys. Sounds kind of interesting. Next, we have one that I'd never heard of. The Battlefield is Here, Showdown at Area 51. And once again, guys, let me say that I appreciate all you guys who comment. And if it's a film that I haven't seen, if you've seen it, let me know what you thought about it. But this one sounds interesting. I mean, every film that I buy, guys, you know, usually if I haven't heard of it, I'll buy it just because I like the way the back sounds. An epic battle of good versus evil. Yeah, I'm sure. On a $200,000 budget. Here's one, guys, that I've kind of heard mixed reviews on this film. It stars Hayden Christensen, and I've seen clips of it. I can remember actually seeing the trailer, and I thought it looked kind of decent. But I mean, I don't know if that's true or not. If it's actually a good film, but it's Jumper, and I know, guys, that in this film we have Samuel L. Jackson, who plays kind of a bad guy, I believe, in this. But from the trailers and everything, it looked like a decent film. I'm going to have to give it a look. I have yet to see this movie, and it's been out for quite some time now. I debated on whether or not to see it in the theater, but I was so burnt by Christensen's performance in the Star Wars prequels, specifically the second one, that I just didn't want to waste my money. Next, we have... I bought this one for just the collector's value. I mean, I have An American Werewolf in London. And this was An American Werewolf in Paris, so I gave it a buy. And I've heard really nothing good about this movie. But, you know, I just like having complete sets. So that's why I bought this one. It says, things are about to get a little hairy. Buzz Weekly gave it 4 stars. This hip, edgy thriller in the electrifying tradition of Scream, Scream 2, and Dusk Till Dawn. Yeah. Next we have, God, this is a movie that was actually produced by Oprah Winfrey's company. And I remember when this was first released on home video, I watched it. And I don't know what it was. Maybe I was halfway interested or just halfway bored or something. But it came across as really kind of strange, really odd movie. It really left a bad taste in my mouth. A lot of it I didn't understand. But I watched it again here about 2 or 3 weeks ago, and the story came across crystal clear. It's definitely a horror film. It's a different kind of horror film. It's about more or less, I guess, a demonic spirit or ghost. Well, let me show you the movie. This is called Beloved. Stars Oprah Winfrey and Danny Glover. And in the film, she loses a daughter at a very young age. And basically, that daughter comes back. She's, well, I guess we can say a ghost or demon spirit takes on the image of her daughter and comes back. And it comes back as a grown woman, but it has the mind of a child. It throws tantrums, and it just pretty much haunts the mom, and it blames the mom for leaving her all those years when it was a baby and she died. But really a decent film, decently made, nice production values. I liked it. I liked it this time around. I will say this is a long, talky film. It takes place during the time where blacks weren't treated so well. But overall, you know, it doesn't really focus on that aspect of the film. It focuses more on the paranormal events in the movie. But overall, I enjoyed it this time around. Not as bad as I remember. Definitely a film that you guys should check out if you have a inkling for those sorts of things. Next, guys, we have... Now, I only bought this one basically because I have the first one. That's the simple truth to the matter. A lot of people really rag on this series of films, and it might be deservedly so. And I even heard this one's really bad, but this is Cabin Fever 2. Now, I have the first one. That's why I got the second one. This time, it's spreading. But there you have it, guys. I don't have a whole lot to say about that. Next, we have a film that, God, you know, I remember the original Halloween, but for the life of me, I think I only saw that film one time many years ago, and one day I'm going to review all those Halloween films, but I think I've got like one, four, and maybe a couple others, but I didn't have this one, saw it at the pawn shop, heard really good things about it, so I picked it up. It's Halloween 2. What was that? I heard something. But anyway, yeah, Halloween 2, guys. I picked it up. Glad to have it. Glad to add it to my collection. Gonna have to give those films a watch. I'm really kind of looking forward to watching them. This is one that I got at the pawn shop for 99 cents. Ridley Scott film. I believe, given the fact that Silence of the Lambs was so popular, the Hannibal Lecter character, that I believe this film came after that, if I'm recalling correctly. Didn't they have, like, Silence of the Lambs, then they had Hannibal, and didn't they have then Red Dragon? Well, this is Hannibal, which was a really successful follow-up to Silence of the Lambs. It introduced this character, and I'd never seen it. Really looking forward to watching it. Great special features on this. Matter of fact, this is a special edition of the film. Ton of special features. Never before seen alternate ending. 35 minutes of deleted scenes and alternate scenes. Feature length commentary by Ridley Scott. 5 unique making of featurettes. I mean, I like to read shit like this because it's just the epitome of what a good DVD consists of. And this is definitely one that got it right. Here's the inside of it, guys. Beautiful, beautiful set. The discs are beautiful. Disc one, disc two. Just beautiful. And then we have an insert here. So, great stuff. Beautiful. Proud to have that. And I only paid 99 cents. Thank you, Blu-ray. Okay, this is one that stars Johnny Depp, the next one. And I had seen this years ago. And this is another one of those films that I just didn't get at the time I saw it. Didn't like it. But someone told me that they really liked this film, and I thought, well, you know, I'm going to give it another look. Because, you know, sometimes you watch a film the first time around and you don't like it, and then you watch it again and you think it's okay. This is Johnny Depp in From Hell, the Director's Limited Edition. Once again, 99 cent, guys. This is a double set. Just beautiful, beautiful set. I mean, that cover art there for the insert. Then you have the discs here that are just beautiful. From Hell. Now, if I recall, this film is about Jack the Ripper. I think Johnny Depp plays more or less a detective, and he discovers who Jack the Ripper is, I believe. It's been so long since I've seen it, guys. But I'm going to give this a shot. Just a great, collection there. That and Hannibal, just excellent looking DVDs. Okay, guys, maybe we can complete this in 30 minutes. I got 4 minutes, but I doubt it. Now we have one classic film. I thought I had this in my collection, but apparently I didn't. And saw it there. Glad to pick it up. But it's Clive Barker's classic, Hellraiser, the original film. Just a classic movie there, guys. What else can you say about Hellraiser? I actually reviewed this in... it was either a month of horror or viewer requests, which I don't think I have it up anymore because it had footage in it, and you know how they feel about footage now. But there's the inside of it, guys. It even has an insert in it. And nice volume. Next we have, I was really surprised to find this, guys, because I have the first one, and it's also an inspiration for my old YouTube name, but it's Phantasm 2. And I love these Phantasm films because to me, they're just really some creative horror movies. Boy! But I just really like these Phantasm films. Not much to it as far as inside. Is that in there good? Yeah, I guess so. There's the inside of it, guys. Just Phantasm 2 on there. Great cover, though. But I just love the Phantasm films. They're just so, to me anyway, creative, innovative. Just like those movies. Another one I was kind of surprised to find, Kiss Your Nerves Goodbye, Roger Ebert. This is Evil Dead 2, which, believe it or not, I don't think I have this movie. I might have it on Blu-ray, I'm not quite sure. I know I've got either Evil Dead or Evil Dead 2, but this is just a classic film. I think Evil Dead 2 is probably my favorite of the series, followed by Army of Darkness and... Then the first one. Matter of fact, guys, the way that art looks in there, it almost, no, that's different. I'm thinking of a different something. But yeah, glad to have Evil Dead 2. The next one is one of a movie I remember seeing on VHS years ago. This movie always struck me as really, I really enjoyed this film, guys. Just thought it was neat. It's one of those films that, you know, precursor to movies like Legion. Whenever a movie depicts God, Satan, the angels. But I definitely think this is one of the better ones out of all those films. This is Christopher Walken in The Prophecy. And if you're into those kind of films with kind of a religious overtones, this is definitely one to pick up. It's not as flashy as the newer ones with the CGI effects. Or, you know, it's just a low-budget film with some good actors. And I really had a good time with this movie. This is one of my favorite, right up there, religious allegory stories. I mean, it has a great cast. I mean, it has Christopher Walken, like I said, who's always just classic. Eric Stoltz is in this. I'm trying to think who else. We had, actually, what I didn't know, I saw this again recently. And guess who the fuck plays Satan? You guys will never guess. And of course, he wasn't a big star when this was made, so I didn't recognize it, but Viggo Mortensen, who plays Aragorn in The Lord of the Rings, plays Satan in this movie, and he fits. I enjoyed this film, guys. I mean, we have Virginia Madsen in this film. Just a really, really good movie. The Prophecy. I think they went on to make like 4 sequels, which I recently just picked up, guys, and I'm going to review all these films someday. So many films, so little time. The last two are two Stephen King films. I've seen both of these. This is Sleepwalkers, which I don't think either one of these are really big hits, but I've always liked Sleepwalker in the fact that the cat is actually a good creature in this, and the evil kind of runs from the cat. Usually evil's with the cat. Like evil pussy. But yeah, this is one of Stephen King's films that I actually liked. And the next Stephen King one we have is Thinner, which I also liked quite a bit, but didn't see it. I think I only seen this like 1 or 2 times, so I don't remember a whole lot about it. But I know the guy was cursed by a gypsy, was it? But Sleepwalkers and Thinner, with Thinner definitely being my favorite of the bunch. And guys, that's where you have it. That's the update this time. I have another one coming up, guys, which are films that I ordered from Amazon that I've got. Not as many as this, but there are some that I need to show you. Who's knocking on my door? Who is it? Man, I don't like nobody coming to my house, man. Call the maintenance. It's forced. What is it?
Your toilet's on crack and water's going all over my floor.
How did the toilet crack?
Yeah. It was loose.
464-6884.
Huh?
Just the one I'll call. 464-6884.
464-6884.
6884? Yeah. All right. These people... I hate to say it, but people that live in apartments, they're fucking idiots. Oh, my toilet cracked. How the fuck did your toilet crack? They never tell the truth. Whenever something breaks, they never tell the fucking truth. Yeah, my toilet just cracked. Oh, what was that? I think my toilet just cracked. Anyway, guys. Nice little piece of information to end this update on. Thanks for watching, everybody. God, this fucking job is a headache. Thanks for watching. Take care, and I'll see you in the next update, which will be Amazon.com movies. See you later.